How to use Cam Studio Recorder for the Windows operating system to create a flip video for your classroom. I'm actually currently using a different software to record this video for Mac, but I'm going to teach you the PC way to do it. So the first thing you need to do is download Cam Studio Recorder. You can do that by going to camstudio.org, as you see right here. And once you go to camstudio.org, you basically just follow the instructions, download the software package. And it is free, there's no cost, and it's limited, but it does everything you need it to do. Once you download Cam Studio, you're going to find that it will create a desktop icon for you if you let it do that. You click the icon and then you come right up here, and it should open up and look just like this. The first thing you want to do is select Options, and then you go down and make sure that it says, see that little check mark there, record audio from microphone. You definitely want to make sure it does that. And you also want to go down here to Program Options. It's not letting me scroll real well in Windows here. And you want to set where it says Directory for Recording. Oops. I'm not going to be able to do it here in Windows. There it goes. Directory for Recording. You're going to want to see that little check mark where it says User Specified Directory. You just click that, and then you set a directory someplace on the computer for Cam Studio to save your video when you're done recording. That way you can find it later. I usually set mine to the My Videos directory, but you can set it wherever is comfortable for you. After you're done with that, the last thing you gotta do is you just have to go up to the record button. You hit record and you'll see that it will start recording. It will give you a countdown of time. And then you're ready to go. You just start your presentation. Let me show you what that looks like. So I'm going to come back onto my Mac side here and show you one of my presentations. I use Prezi, Prezi.com. It's also free, and you can create a presentation here, but you could also do it in PowerPoint or however else you could imagine it. So I start, and I have my presentation going, and you just click through it, and you talk just like you'd be giving a presentation in class. It's no different, except for it's going to record just your screen and your voice, so you don't have to see your face there. Unless you want your face there, then you can record that too. So you go through your presentation. A couple pointers for presentations you might notice. You want to try and keep your text to be limited. You don't want to have like big paragraphs of text. I try to come up with some interesting photos to show kids. Some that are pretty funny. You may have noticed that my intro slide had the Burger King man. Something to keep it light, a little bit humorous. It definitely helps keep their engagement a little bit more. And the biggest thing about making these videos is you, no matter what you're teaching, you're going to want to keep your video between 8 and 10 minutes, which might mean that you have to do one video per skill or per topic. You can't really combine them together, because if you do more than 10 minutes, you're definitely not going to have kids watching the whole thing. It's just too long for the kids to pay attention outside of school. So 8 to 10 minutes tends to be the sweet spot, and you definitely want to somehow interject some sort of lightness or humor or comedy, whether it be through pictures or through a story or through how you dictate the video. Okay, so once you're done with your presentation, what you need to do is find where you saved it. So if you use Cam Studio and set your default recording place, you see I set it to My Videos, and you see I have a video saved in there called Flip Video, which is one I recorded with Cam Studio earlier. And then the last step is just to upload that video to the internet. So I like to use YouTube, because that is a place where I go a lot for that kind of stuff. And I like YouTube because it's not blocked in our school, most importantly, and it is available on any device. So whether you have an iPhone, an Android, a PC, a Mac, kids can go to YouTube and the video will play. Sometimes if you use other sites or other video hosting services, you might run into some compatibility issues. That will not be a problem with YouTube, no matter how much people don't like YouTube sometimes. It's perfect for this particular thing. So if you can use YouTube, it's great. So I'm signed in. I have a YouTube account called EMS History 12 that is just for my social studies class. So kids aren't going to see my home videos I might post on YouTube or anything like that. I have my own account, which if you're going to use YouTube, I'd encourage you to set up. They're free to set up, so you can set up as many accounts as you want. And all you do, it's very simple. You just click Select Files from your computer, and you find where your video is. And wherever your movie is. And then once it's there, you just click open, upload, and you're ready to go, and that's it. If I were to click open now, the file would start to upload to YouTube. And then once it's in YouTube, you can give kids the link to that video, and they could then start accessing that video and from home, from their phones, from anywhere, and then they're going to be learning at home, and you've created your flip video. There's obviously some other options in YouTube that you can set up for privacy, for other things, to disallow comments if you're concerned about those kind of things. Just let me know and I'll help you through that. So I hope this helped you guys learn how simple it really is to create a screen recording of your computer. It's very, very easy. It's very low tech, and it doesn't take long, and it's a great way to make a flip video.